to do it, so. Now.
Good morning.
Good morning.
God is good.
All the time.
My name is Al, and a few years ago, I cut out a article in the paper, and I can't remember if it was the Republic or it was the Dispatch, but it kind of grabbed me, and I wanted to read this to you today. I read it a couple years ago at Quail Run. In 1926, a preacher named James A. Francis gave a description of Jesus in a well-known sermon. Here is a man who was born in an obscure village, Bethlehem, a child of a peasant woman. He grew up in another obscure village, Nazareth. He worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30, and then for 3 years he was an itinerant preacher. He never wrote a book. He never held office. He never owned a home. He never had a family. He never went to college. He never set foot in a large town. He never traveled 200 miles from the place he was born. He never did any of the things that usually accompany greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He had nothing to do with this world except the naked power of his divine manhood. While still a young man, the tide of popular opinion turned against him. His friends ran away. One of them denied him. Another betrayed him. He was turned over to his enemies. He went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed upon a cross between two thieves. His executioners gambled for the only piece of property he had on earth while he was dying. When he was dead, he was taken down and laid in a borrowed grave through the pity of a friend. 2,000 years have gone by, and today he is the center of the human race. No one has affected the life of man upon the earth as powerfully as this one solitary life. What child is this? He is God in a human body subject to the characteristics of humanity. In Colossians 2:9, in him, all the fullness of deity dwells in the bodily form. Jesus came as a man yet in full possession of his divine nature. What child is this? As our Savior, he walked among men, bringing the New Testament through his shed blood and the broken body on the cross. He brought a message of freedom through forgiveness of sin. He brought a message that bridged the gap between mankind and our Father in heaven. He brought a message of love for the Father and for all our fellow man. We use this time of year to celebrate his birth, which is not what he asked of us. He said to love the Father with all your heart, mind, strength, and love others as he had loved us. This giving of gifts and sharing our possessions with others is not just a special one-time event this time of year. He said, as my Father loved me, so I have loved you. Continue in my love. No greater love has a man. No greater love has a man than to lay down his life for others.
Amen. Amen.
Sorry. We lay our lives aside when we share our blessed possession with others. He said to carry his message of love, bearing the good news of our salvation in the darkness of this world. May the light of Christ continue to shine brightly through those who believe upon this child,
that was born Savior of the world.
Amen.
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 When the Lord touches your heart, isn't it? When the Lord comes into your heart, and when you invite Him into your heart, that's the greatest gift you've ever received, if you've ever received it. And it's the greatest gift you ever will receive, if you have not yet. You may have a list a mile long of people that you're supposed to buy gifts for, and you didn't know what to give them. Didn't want to spend a lot of money on them. Maybe you did want to spend a lot of money on them and couldn't. Maybe you could give them the gift of Jesus. That's what He came for, and that's what Christmas is all about.
Amen.
Can you think back before you knew the Lord, if somebody would have offered you the gift of Jesus, how that would have affected your life to today and beyond? So think about that and consider giving the gift of Jesus. He's already given Himself. He's just trying to make sure everybody knows and has an opportunity to receive their gift. Amen. All right. Here's another song we have on our CD. But the Lord said, do the other version. And so listen to this.
When he suddenly stopped as he stitched the twine and he said, old friends, at dawn today when the cock was crowing the night away, the Lord appeared in a dream to me and said, I'm coming your guest to be. So I've been busy with feet astir, strewing my shop with branches of fir. The table is spread and the kittle is shine, and over the rafters the holly is twined. And now I'll wait for my Lord to appear and listen closely, so I will hear His step as He nears my humble place, and I open the door and look on His face. So his friends went home and left Conrad alone, for this was the happiest day he had known, for long since his family had passed away, and Conrad had spent many a sad Christmas day. But he knew with the Lord as his Christmas guest, this Christmas would be the dearest and best. So he listened with only joy in his heart, and with every sound he would rise with a start and look for the Lord to be at his door, like the vision he had a few hours before. So he ran to the window after hearing a sound, but all he could see on the snow-covered ground was a shabby beggar whose shoes were torn, and all of his clothes were ragged and worn. But Conrad was touched, and he went to the door and he said, your feet must be frozen and sore. I have some shoes in my shop for you, and a coat that will keep you warmer too. So with grateful heart the man went away. But Conrad noticed the time of day, and he wondered what made the Lord so late and how much longer he'd have to wait. When he heard a knock, he ran to the door, but it was only a stranger once more, a bent old lady with a shawl of black, with a bundle of kindling piled on her back. She asked for only a place to rest, but that was reserved for Conrad's great guest. But her voice seemed to plead, don't send me away. Let me rest for a while on Christmas Day. So Conrad brewed her a steaming cup and told her to sit at the table and sup. But after she left, he was filled with dismay, for he saw that the hours were slipping away and the Lord hadn't come as he said he would. And Conrad felt sure he had misunderstood. When out of the stillness he heard a cry, please help me and tell me where am I? So again he opened his friendly door and stood disappointed as tears and quieted all her childish fears. Then he led her back to her home once more. But as he entered his own darkened door, he knew that the Lord was not come today, for the hours of Christmas had passed away. So he went to his room and knelt down to pray, and he said, "Dear Lord, why did you delay? What kept you from coming to call on me? For I wanted so much your face to see." When soft in the silence a voice he heard, "Lift up your head, for I kept my word. 3 times my shadow crossed your floor. 3 times I came to your lowly door. For I was the beggar with bruised cold feet. I was the woman you gave something to eat. And I was the child on the homeless street. 3 times I knocked. 3 times I came in. And each time I found the warmth of a friend. Gifts, love is the best. I was honored to be your Christmas guest."
Amen. And have you all heard that before? Any of you heard it before? I think it's Helen Steiner Rice that wrote that, and Grandpa Jones is the one that's
recognized that.
Yes. Yes. So in Matthew 22:36-40, and just keeping in mind that video we just saw and that poem we just heard and everything else we've heard today. Mm-hmm. "Teacher, which is the most important commandment in the law of Moses?" And Jesus replied, and this is in red letters, that matters to you because this is his words. "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. The second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. The entire law and all the demands of the prophets are based on these two commandments." Loving God and loving others. If you love God, you will love others. I think that's John 7 that says, "If you love me, you will keep my commands." And then we're going to read Luke 1:26-35. And I'll be reading in the New King James. And then I'm going to read some more over in Luke 2. "Now in the 6th month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to the city of Galilee, named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, 'Rejoice, highly favored one. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.' But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, 'Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David.'" I'll make sure I'm reading the Bible. Okay. "And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Then Mary said to the angel, 'How can this be, since I do not know a man?' And the angel answered and said to her, 'The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore, also, the Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God.'" Amen. Then I'm going to read verse 38. Then Mary said, "Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to what your word." And the angel departed from her. And so basically she said, "Okay, whatever you say." And then Luke 2, 1 through 20. "And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men.' So it was when the angel had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, 'Let's go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us.' And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen and was told to them." We're going to sing a song that summarizes everything we just read there, and then we're going to talk just a little.
There are people who are whispering, and the rumors are running wild. And there's a woman who's not married, but she's gonna have a child. And her name is Mary, and she's a virgin from down in Nazareth. Now listen close. She's gonna marry a man named Joseph, but the Mary's father is the Holy Ghost. Who do you think would buy such a thing? Would believe that this story is true? Such a thing. Well, here's hope.